You know, Peter McNeely, despite the fact that he was really rocked and wobbled that second time, wanted to continue. And I jumped the gun, but I'm going to say that the fight is stopped, and Peter McNeely is stopping, but actually it was his corner that stopped the fight. He wanted to continue.
He's coming to us and stopping. He's not going to bring up to me and be another fight right here with my corner, because let's face it, we know what you've chosen. The man is a man that has to go out for that. He had made it to the finals so much better than most people thought. Most people thought he'd walk out there, he didn't fall down, end the story. He came in like he hit my shot, on top of the head. He took his chances, he got his licks in, he's bound to fight.
Peter McNeely, a gutsy kid from Medfield, Massachusetts. He came in with a reputation for a mediocre club fighter, and later, who just fought a big race. And this crowd, very disappointed, very upset that this fight was in the back.
I agree with you, 100%.
All right, let's go to Jim Graham.
I am. Both, Jeff.
All right, thank you very much, Steve. Mike, your thoughts on your interview?
It's not fair. Well, goddamn it, I want to ask 50 seconds or whatever. I will give you $2 for the goddamn fight.
Are you surprised with the... that you only came in
the second?
Well, I'm going to Toledo, at least. Well, so if it's in Michigan, you talk about it's going to take four.
You should be on his corner. Should his corner man...
You got to leave at 6 o'clock. You better get up. You want me to come by or what? Further than that. You be in my house at 6 o'clock, I'll be ready to go. 6 o'clock exactly. Alright, man, don't fuck up.
You're not coming here to see.
Alright.
And this is another.
Like watching it in the movie.
On their way to the fire.
Even there, where you see them or not.